नमस्कार, ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेलकम इन दिस निःशुल्क IAS ऑनलाइन प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर द सिविल सर्विस प्रिपरेशन एंड इन द सीरीज वी आर डिस्कसिंग द क्लास 6 NCERT ज्योग्राफी वेयर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इन द टू पार्ट्स एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ क्लास 6 NCERT ज्योग्राफी इन द थ्री पार्ट्स. In the first part, we will be discussing the basic concept. In the second part or the second lecture, we will be discussing the latitudes and the longitudes. And in the third lecture or the third part, we will be discussing how we can determine the time on the various locational points or at the various places on the earth. What is the calculation for the determination of the time on the different places of the earth? So, for the time calculation to locate any given place on the earth on the minutely basis, to study the different climatic region of the earth with a certain algorithm pattern, we have discussed or we have drawn or the human community has drawn some imaginary lines on the earth. In reality, there is no such kind of line which we are calculating at presently on the earth, but for the certain locational points or the certain reference point, the scientific community or the geographers has given or drawn the certain imaginary lines on the earth. So on the earth, two kind of imaginary lines have been drawn. Imaginary lines. And those are, first, latitudes, that is horizontal, or we will write over here only the horizontal, and the second is vertical. In the horizontal, we have the perfect example of full circle line. Those are latitudes. And in the vertical, there is another subdivision, that is straight and semicircle. In the straight, we have the example of axis, and in the semicircle, we have the example of longitudes, right? So the imaginary lines, we have the two kinds of the imaginary line, the vertical, horizontal and vertical. In the horizontal, we have the example four circle latitudes, and the vertical, we have the two division, straight and semicircle. In the straight, we have the example of axis, and the semicircle, we have the example of longitudes. Right? Now, look. So first we will discuss some important terminologies given in this chapter. And the first terminology is globe. What is globe? As I have already discussed or given the definition of the globe in the previous lecture or the previous chapter. So globe is a kind of true but miniature model of the earth. Globe is a kind of true but the miniature model of the earth. So this is globe. In the globe, we see earth in a complete sphere form. In the globe, we used to see earth in the complete sphere form, but actually the earth is not in the ideal sphere form. It is a some kind of compression on the pole and bulge in the middle. So this shape of the earth, as we have already discussed, is known as geoid, where we have the compression on the earth on the pole, and bulge at middle. So the globe is the perfect true miniature model of the earth in the perfect spherical form. But in reality, the earth is not in the ideal spherical form. Second important terminology is axis. So what is axis? So suppose this is earth and this is the center of earth, right? So that imaginary line, this is north pole and this one is south pole. So that imaginary line which is passing from inside the earth, that imaginary line which has drawn inside the earth, which is a straight and passing through the center of earth, that imaginary line which has been drawn inside the earth, not the surface on the earth, inside the earth. Suppose, so now imagine this is north pole and this one is south pole. So in the globe we have a connecting rod inside this globe. If we imagine that this is the earth, so that connecting rod which is connecting north pole and the south pole from inside the earth known as axis. And this imaginary line which is straight in the shape passing through the center known as axis. Axis, right? So axis is an imaginary line. It is a straight in its form or shape and it is passing through the center of the earth which has been drawn inside the earth known as axis. It is the example of vertical imaginary line. Next important terminology is equator. So what is equator? Equator example hai horizontal and equator is a latitude, right? So imagine this is earth right. So that imaginary line which has been drawn in the middle of the earth, right? So properties is imaginary in middle of earth and making a complete circle over the earth, right? Imaginary in middle, complete circle and dividing earth into two equal halves. And those halves are North Hemisphere and South Hemisphere. Right? Look over here. So that imaginary line, which is the example of the latitude or the horizontal type of line, and that has been drawn in the middle of the earth, middle of the earth, and that's how it is dividing the earth into the two equal halves. So one half or the upper half is known as North Hemisphere, and the second half is known as South Hemisphere, known as equator. Equator means equate, equally. So this imaginary line, which is known as equator, divides the earth into the two equal halves known as equator. It is imaginary, just in the middle of the earth, making a complete circle around the earth, and the total length of this circle is 40,075 kilometer. That's why it is also known as equatorial circumference. Right? Equatorial circumference, because this is the equator. That dark blue color line in the middle, this is the equator, making a complete circle around the earth. The total length of this complete circle is 40,075 kilometer. That's why it is also known as equatorial circumference of the earth. Right? Next important terminology is important reference point. So the on the earth, given on the two types of the imaginary line, equator known as important reference point. That means equator is acting as a base or the foundation for the calculation or the important reference points in context of the given place, in context of the seasonal studies, in context of the different kinds of geographical studies. Right? That means, that's why the value of the equator is 0 degree. And we count the equator neither in the hemisphere nor in the south hemisphere. So the equator is in itself is a separate latitudinal line. That's why on the earth we have the total counting of the latitudinal line is 181, where the 1 is equator, 90 is of the north pole and 90 of the south pole. We will discuss it in the next lecture. So the equator is also known as important reference point of the earth. Right? Next important terminology is Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn. Again, this is Earth and this line is equator. Right? So this must be axis. Yes, this is axis. Ideally, this is the situation where ideally the axis and the equator both are in the straight form or looking like a straight line on the earth. But in reality, earth has an inclination. Earth is inclined on its axis in the west direction by 23.5 degree west. If this angle is 23.5 degree west, then this must be also the 23.5 degree, right? If this is the situation, then the equator must also be adjusted. If the equator is forming a 90 degree angle over here, then it has to also form the 90 degree angle over here. That's why the equator also repositioned itself in this manner. So this is the lowest point of equator. And this is the highest point. Right? If this is to be done, then the 90 degree angle is formed over here. In the ideal condition, this was the 90 degree angle between the axis and the equator. And because the axis has inclined to the 23.5 degree west, then simultaneously the equator has also adjusted itself by the 23.5 and 23.5 degree. From the highest point, we draw a straight line. From the highest point, we draw a straight line known as Tropic of Cancer. And from the lowest point, we again draw a straight line known as Tropic of Capricorn. And this is how we came out with the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. One additional point, the region behind this Tropic of Capricorn and the Tropic of Cancer known as Torrid Zone. So the value of the Tropic of Cancer is 23.5 degree north and the Tropic of Capricorn is 23.5 degree south. Right? Again, in the next analogy, Arctic Circle or Antarctic Circle. Now, at 66.5 degree north, we have the Arctic Circle. And 66.5 degrees south, Antarctic Circle. Why again we have this kind of circle? So look, in the middle of the Tropic of Cancer to the Tropic of Capricorn, the sun rays are always vertical. From the Tropic of the Cancer toward the Antarctic Circle, and the from the Tropic of Capricorn toward the Antarctic Circle, the sun rays start to slanting. Tirchi hona start to slanting. And beyond this degree, the effect of the temperature is going to minimize gradually towards North Pole in the Northern Hemisphere and towards South Pole in the Southern Hemisphere. That's why the region from where the effect of the heat of the sunlight or the effect of the heat of the sun temperature going to be marginalized gradually, then this circle known as Antarctic Circle in the Northern Hemisphere and the Southern Hemisphere, it is known as Antarctic Circle. Beyond that, at the 90 degree, we have North Pole in the Northern Hemisphere and South Pole in Southern Hemisphere. Right? First we had the axis. Axis is a straight line drawn inside the Earth, passing through the center of the Earth, connecting North Pole to the South Pole. This is the axis. Axis has inclination of 23.5 degree west. Equator, that line which has been drawn in the middle of the Earth and making a complete circle around the Earth, known as equator. The value of the equator is 0 degree and the length of the equator is 40 degree 75 kilometer. This also known as a important reference point, and this is also known as a Earth equatorial circumference. because the axis has the inclination of the 23.5 degree west, then equator has also had then the equator has also adjusted to itself according to the inclination. So the 90 degree angle must be completed, and that's why in the southern hemisphere the equator goes to the lowest point, and in the northern hemisphere equator adjusted to the highest point. From the lowest points we are drawing our imaginary straight line known as Tropic of the Cancer, and from the highest point again we are drawing an imaginary straight line known as the Tropic of the Cancer. The value of the Tropic of the Cancer is 23.5 degree north in the northern hemisphere, and the value of the Tropic of the Cancer is 23.5 degree south 23.5 degree south in the southern hemisphere. Important terminology, next one is prime meridian and eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere. Now what is this prime meridian? As we have discussed in the vertical lines that we had the two division, straight line and semicircle line. So now we are moving to the semicircle line, because in the straight line example we have studied the axis. So this is the earth again, and on the earth, this is the earth again, and on the earth we have drawn the vertical semicircle lines. That means these line has been drawn on the surface of the earth, vertical semicircle line. That means these line has been drawn on the surface of the earth, and again connecting both the pole, that means connecting north pole to the south pole or connecting the south pole to the north pole. So the baseline from where we start to calculate the valuations of the longitude known as prime meridian. This is north pole and this is south pole, and a semicircle line which has been drawn over the surface of the earth and connecting north pole to the south pole known as longitude, and the baseline of that longitude known as prime meridian. Prime meridian, semicircle, it is a semicircle line connecting north pole to the south pole or vice versa, right? The valuation of the prime meridian is 0 degree. The value of the prime meridian is 0 degree, correct? Now, just opposite to the prime meridian, so if this is to be the prime meridian, this one, where we have the prime meridian, this one, if this is the prime meridian, it is a semicircle. And just opposite to the prime meridian, we have a 180 degree longitude, right? So the 0 degree longitude, 180 degree longitude makes a complete polar circumference. Polar circumference. Polar circumference is the combination of the 0 degree prime meridian plus 180 degree longitude. The total length of the polar circumference is 40,008 km. In the equatorial circumference the distance was 40,075 km. In the polar circumference, the distance is 40,008 km. The difference of length between the polar circumference and the equatorial circumference against proof that the earth is a geoid shaped structure, right? So polar circumference
which is the combination of the prime meridian and the 180 degree longitude, divides the earth again into the two equal halves, and these equal halves are vertical. So if we say imaginary halves of the earth, then first we have the subdivision of those half. The first division is horizontal, and the second division is vertical. In the horizontal, we have North Hemisphere plus South Hemisphere, and in the vertical we have Eastern Hemisphere plus Western Hemisphere. Right? So this one is Eastern Hemisphere, E-A-S-T-E-R-N, Eastern Hemisphere, and this one is Western Hemisphere. Right? If we used to draw, some kind of mashup will be there, but you people have to adjust for the timing. If we draw equator, then this portion is North Hemisphere, and this one portion is South Hemisphere. And that's how we have the four equal imaginary halves on the earth. Two are the horizontal, North Hemisphere, South Hemisphere, and two are the vertical, Eastern Hemisphere and Western Hemisphere. All this is the imaginary calculation. So the important terminology we have discussed in the first lecture for the time being, and from here now we will move to the second lecture, that means the study of the latitude and the longitude in the second part. So for the time being, Jai Hind and Vande Mataram. Thank you.